this class and the method is not supported in Lightning. Okay, so this window.location code was written in one of the Visual Force pages for which there's a workaround. So in Lightning, there's a different way through which you can write this code of window.location. So if you want to open a different window from your Visual Force page, you need to replace this one with a syntax which is compatible in Lightning. Similarly, there are certain JavaScript JavaScript code which is also supported in Lightning, but obviously once we do the conversion, we have to see whether the page is rendering properly in Lightning or not. So this shows you the different kind of effort categories which are required for every component in Lightning. So it can be some part of the code which is not compatible, it can be the review activity, because even if it is supported, we have to go to the page, see whether it is rendering properly or not, whether every button is functioning the way it is supposed to function. So review activity is also involved. And then similarly, static URLs are not supported. So for the static URLs, again, there's a workaround once you start looking into it. So accordingly, so these issues, window.location, static URL, this was specific to another client. So once you do the scanning of Visual Force pages and see the issues there, maybe the issues will differ. But these are broader categories which are mainly found in these Lightning migration projects.
Okay. Yeah.
So, and then we have the Visual Force pages which are supposed to migrate to Lightning. So we might identify some of the Visual Force pages which are not, like, they have so many issues and we don't even have workarounds for them in Lightning. So in that case, we might need to move the logic of the Visual Force page to a Lightning component or a Lightning web component. That's another category of Visual Force pages. So we will see once we scan it, once you look into it, when you start digging it more, we'll see under which categories, which different Visual Force pages will lie, whether just a small code refactor will work, whether just simple conversion will work, or we need to completely revamp it and convert it into LC or LWC.
Okay, got it.
So, yeah. And then similarly, we have custom. Let me do one thing. Let me share this with you. And the important columns which will help you is item, identification criteria, and categorization on efforts needed. So just read these three columns. Okay. You will get the fair idea on which components, what kind of actions we kind of need to perform, right? So like sidebar components. So sidebar components are not supported in Lightning. So for them, the effort will be needed in terms of we might need to convert them into the utility option, which is there in Lightning, or we need to create the quick actions for them.
Okay.
So that is the way. So these are the components, these are the criteria of identification for these components, and then what efforts will be needed for Lightning migration. Its categorization is in this column.
Okay, yeah, I will do that. So after fixing that, after the testing, right?
So in terms of steps, you have written the step that first step is your, you will see all the Visual Force pages, right?
Yeah.
Then you will see whether the Lightning is enabled or not. Then third, you will apply the Lightning style sheets to them and then see which has fully converted, which is partially converted. Fully converted, no issue. The only thing which you need to do in fully converted is you have to go to that page in Lightning Experience and see whether everything is working fine, all controls, everything is working fine or not. Only review activity applicable. But if any issues are there, maybe partially completed, or maybe there are so many page issues, then we have to drill down into page issues and see which code is not compatible and then what is the compatible code for the same logic in Lightning Experience.
And I have one question. Enabling that checkboxes, then how we will get to know these issues we got?
There's a page issues column which will come up. There's a page issues column in which you will get the count of the page issues, and once you drill down it, it will show you the lines of code also where there is the issue.
Okay,
so it will come through the Lightning converter. So you just have to drill down on it and see what are the page issues. and then you have to start working on the compatible code version of it. So what I will recommend, first do the identification, directly do the identification of what is the compatible code in Lightning for the piece of code which is not supported. Write it down maybe in Excel itself, and then we will do a review, and then we will start making changes to the code itself.
Yeah, sure.
But first we have to put it in the Excel sheet. Okay. Since you are doing it for the first time, that's why, right? So we will first put it into Excel, we will see whether it's fine or not, and then we will move it to the actual code, or compile it, and then we will basically test it in the test environment.
Okay.
Okay, so first let me share it. You should ask HR Lakshmi to disable one of them, because it becomes confusing. I just keep on forgetting. So this one you are using, right?
Yes.
Lakshmi at the rating.
Yeah, Lakshmi. I will ask him. I will check with them.
Yeah. Just tell them to remove one of them. Yeah. So you can go through this one, and let's just focus on Visual Force pages to start with, and then let's
also
go step by step.
Also, you have any references to solve these issues? Like previously, have you done anything to solve this? Like any references?
See, references, everything is there on trailheads and the documentations which are there, right?
Yeah.
So you need not to, first of all, you need not to worry that you are working on it for the first time. I do understand it. So accordingly, the time estimation, or basically how much time is allotted to you, will be based upon that only. So I won't expect you to do something in one day from Lightning migration perspective if you are taking it 3 days on it, because you are doing it for the first time. So it will take more time for you compared to a person who has already worked in Lightning migration. So the time will be allotted based upon the complexity itself, Lakshmi. That's one. And in terms of references, everything is there in trailheads and documentation of Salesforce, right? So those are the only references.
Yeah,
I will also give it the same references.
Okay.
So just go through them, yeah, and make a list out of it in terms of issues and what are the workarounds being recommended by Salesforce, and let's take it forward from there.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
So daily, at what time we can connect?
Yeah, so let me fix it up. So tomorrow it is holiday for you.